one bike that struck me the second I walked in was a bike called a Victor. It's everything I like about old items. It's phenomenally well designed. It's quirky, it's different, and it's exciting to see. Ooh, I know what that is. That I love. There you go. That's the beginning of cycling. That's the birth of cycling right there. So what age is that?
1869, English.
Wow. So that would have been made by a Cartwright.
Yes.
Bicycles, they weren't called bicycles, they were Boneshakers, weren't they? Boneshakers. I've got to ask, what's that worth? A lot.
A lot.
Everywhere you look here, there are rare bikes. Now, these are bikes where there'll be a handful left in the world. We open one shed door and he's got a real Boneshaker. A real one, from the 19th century. Incredible thing.
The Boneshaker was one of the first types of bicycle with pedals. It was invented in the 1860s in France and manufactured by the Michaud Company, who referred to it as a velocipede. It's earned its nickname due to the extremely uncomfortable ride because of the wrought iron frame and wooden wheels with iron tires. Few originals exist today, as most were melted down for the metal during World War I. Today, a Boneshaker could sell for around £5,000.
Two things not original. The seat.
Yep.
Because the mice had eaten the seat.
Yep.
And two spokes in the front wheel, which I broke in a race.
And that's it. You raced,
you raced it?
I did.
You're my new hero now.
Eh?
Eh?
World Championship Boneshaker race.
That's fantastic. Paul's enthusiasm for bikes is infectious. You walk in here, I defy anybody, even if you're not interested in bikes, to walk in here and not go, wow, that's exciting. And the range he's got in here is phenomenal.
Although Paul wouldn't want to part with his rare bikes...
Where are we going now?
Bottom end.
There are things here he'd be happy to sell.
Oh, yeah, now you're talking. Great sign.
You like?
Yeah, I like everything here. I like that.
Do you?
Yes.
What have we spotted?
That lamp, look at that.
Ah.
You've put that on it?
I did. It's a fire engine search lamp.
Yeah. Great base. It's just I've had that base before.
Ah. Uh-huh.
It's just a normal industrial machinist's.
Yes, yes.
That's fantastic. There's work to do. It's been painted a horrible colour with Neffol paint, which we'll have to strip that right back to the steel. There's a bend in it that's going to have to be fixed, and also it's going to have to be rewired. So there's not an easy one, needs work, but it looks great. And what we do is really find things that look great.
This light, once restored and rewired, could have a value of £600.
Would that be something you want to sell?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Go on then, hit us with a price. You're obviously very good at buying and selling stuff, so.
I'm not, actually.
You must, really?
No, I'm awful.
Oh, you just go, I gotta have it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Like you.
There is some judgment involved, but it's slim.
Minimal.
Minimal. No, I love it. Love it. I'd be really, really interested in that. So what would it take to buy it?
400.
Too much. Starting point. Starting point. I'm gonna go straight in with my best offer then.
Yes.
£200.
How's 2.5?
I don't want to argue over £50, really, but...
Good.
You said you were no good at this.
I'm not.
It's better than me today. I'm having an off day. I'm having an off week, actually, aren't I? Yeah.
Don't play poker.
Oh, no, I'm a rank outsider when you go
to
this.
Oh, dear. 225. Sold. Thank you. Oh, I like the bike. Is that an original?
Yeah, 1940.
Did you buy this in the States, one of your finds? It's always the girls' bikes, aren't they, that aren't so battered. Little things like having the original grips, which are in perfect condition as well with the tassels. Then the original pedals are on. It says, well, they've got hardly any wear. There's very little damage to it, and it's complete. So all the little side panels, you know, the faux sort of fuel tank, it's all there. All the screws are there. Nothing's missing, including the sort of Buck Rogers-esque lamp on the front of it, and its original lens. I mean, this thing's just getting better and better and better.
This girl's bicycle dates from 1940 and was made by the Columbia Bike Factory in Westfield, Massachusetts. This deluxe model has a lot of desirable extras. It could be worth around £600.
It's got five and you could have it for £295. That sounds so much better.
What did you say, £250?
I had to buy it and ship it from America. £290.
£290.
That's the original saddle and everything.
Yeah. And it's definitely 1940.
Definitely.
Definitely, definitely.
Definitely.
Certainly looks like it, doesn't it? Yeah, yeah. It's a stylish and fun thing, but it's also a place in time. Bigger is better, more is good. That's what that bike takes you. Bit of window art, isn't it, for the shop?
Yeah.
But it's the sort of thing, it's the sort of fun thing. These really interest me. So tell me about this one. I've never seen a pickup truck.
This is an FD. It's 150cc again.
Rare?
Yes, quite rare, yeah. Very expensive. For this one, for instance, would cost between £8,000 and £9,000.
One scooter in particular has caught Drew's eye.
As we walked in, I like the look of this.
Yeah.
So tell me about this. What year is this? Is this 50s?
Yeah, it's a Series 2 LD. It's 1956.
Yeah.
It's mostly original. It's been hand-painted, but it's not too bad.
I like that.
And the little mirror, yeah.
I like that a lot.
Lambretta's LD model scooters were first launched in 1951 and were part of their more luxurious range. They came with pillion seats as standard and reached a top speed of 50 miles per hour. This bike could be worth around £2,500.
I would sell it for £2,000.
Tempting, isn't it? I just like the shape and I like the originality. So can I make you an offer on it? Open to offers, because I've got to get a deal.
Otherwise, of course, I'm open to offers.
It's in my nature, I can't help it. I've got a figure in mind, I don't know if you'll accept it, of £1,500. Take it away.
I really can't accept that. I bought it for that amount of money. I've spent another £100 on it, and I've got to make a little bit of profit on it as well.
18?
1850.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, love it. Marvellous. No, thank you very much. There you go. Bought Lambretta.
Ride it home.
You are. We can go out for a little Sunday rise on this tea. I think this is quite a small investment that might have a small return, but I don't think I'm going to lose money. But if somebody comes and offers me £100 profit on it tomorrow, they can have it. You've got to be able to let things go.